So who are you up against in this lane?
Syndra.
Syn Ooh, okay. All right. Whew. Syndra may be annoying when she throws her ultimate at you. There's no way of avoiding that. So, all right. So in this lane, you're facing against Syndra middle, Kog'Maw AD carry, Teemo top, Leona. All right. So let's take a look at this one. Let me actually juggle this around. All right. Aurelio was top lane, Corki AD carry, Lee Sin jungle, Teemo top. All right. So let's talk about this one. All right, so you're starting off with Doran's Ring. All right, that's completely fine. So we're gonna go into laning phase here. Now this is player preference. It's either you can start with W or your Q. Either one. Most people start off with W. Some people start off with Q to push the lane. So,
yeah.
All right, so that's player preference. There's no correct build path on that. But what did you max first?
I max Q first.
Good. All right. Max Q first. Last max is the E, of course. And of course, you're going to get your W second.
Yeah.
All right. So we're going to skip laning phase here. All right. We're going to hide the minions, red side here. So we're going to put Fog of War. All right. Let's take a look at this one. All right. All right. So the blue card. All right. So you're just juggling the lanes here. You're going to, CS that one, get that. Oh, okay, so that was a little bit of a miss here.
Oh, I see. Oh,
right,
okay.
So we're gonna see. Ooh, okay, there's the red card. Alright, so we'll see how you do here. We're gonna speed this up a bit, go through laning phase. Alright. This is very Dune. Okay. We'll see this one. Alright, so you're pushing the lane. It's still early. You don't really need to ward. There's not much pressure here. I want to skip through this. Let's see. Okay, you have to be careful with your CS. Because these are easy CS where you cannot just miss. Alright?
Okay.
You gotta focus. Every CS counts. Alright, let's see here. I want to talk about harassing your opponent lane as well. See, like, for example... For example, I want to talk about... Oh, why are you here? Alright, so we're going to talk a little bit more about this one. Here, this is the one. Okay, on this one, tell me, why are you trying to pressure the lane? Or why are you trying to push the lane?
To be honest, I'm not too sure.
See, okay, now here's the thing. You're pushing the lane, allowing her to farm under a tower, and making yourself vulnerable to ganks. You don't always have to pull the red card, and also, if you're pulling out red card, gold card, you're consuming your mana. It's best to slowly farm with your blue card until you get your E. Once you get your E, then the harassing begins. But on this kind of a situation, they have a Nidalee jungler, of course, but it can be any jungler. Don't push a lane so hard so early.
Okay.
Leave it in the center here. Don't get too pushed back, and don't push so hard. Just keep it in the center. And just farm up, because you and Syndra are playing safe, and who's winning trades? You are. So there's no need to push her all the way back in the tower and get yourself vulnerable to ganks. Just keep it in the center, alright? Alright, so we're gonna skim through this one. You're winning trades. Alright, whoops. Alright, so you missed a couple CS here. Alright, so I want to talk about this one as well. Where is Syndra right now?
Middle of the lane.
Alright, middle of the lane. It looks like here, they're gonna gank you. How she's positioned, because what does Syndra have? Stun.
Yeah.
She has a stun. And then look at you. Alright, so let's first talk about it. Is there any wards around the map?
No.
Okay, so there's no wards around the map, there's no vision, and you're playing a little bit overly aggressive here. Now this is the time to study your opponent's pattern. What is Syndra trying to do?
Send me to the brush right there.
No, she's not trying to send you in the brush. She's trying to stun you. She's trying to do something to you. She's preparing for an attack on you. So when you look at the opponent, like for example, let's jump back 15 seconds. You see how Syndra's just playing completely passive? See like that?
Yes.
She's just playing passive. Now slowly, look how her gameplay changed. We're gonna skim through this where you throw the red card. And look at this one. She slowly engages on you. There you go. She starts walking. You start walking to her. Alright? So you're just farming CS. And there you go. She starts changing her pattern right here. She's getting closer to you. There you go. You see how close that is?
Yeah.
So when you see your opponent change his pattern, that means something's gonna happen. The moment they're so close to you, they want something to happen. So here, I'm gonna, for example, think Nidalee's gonna be close. Oh, wait. Okay, so this is... Alright, so she did it. Alright, so she didn't gank. She was way too close. She wasn't setting up anything. And she's eating your auto. So let's talk about this one. Nidalee was down here. You saw the spear. Now, since you already warded here, since you already know she's down here, you know that you can hug this side. Now, let's talk about blue cards as well. Your mana's already halfway, and you have a card up. You see how close she is? You're supposed to be hitting her.
Okay.
At this point, okay, because I've seen this at a higher level. That's why I was a little confused. I understand, you know, this is a bronze game, and we're gonna learn on how to harass our opponent. From this point out, look at, she's so close. And what do you have up?
My card.
Your card. What could you have done?
Probably stun her or blue card her.
No, okay. You stun her, throw a Q, back off. You win the trade. Because here, she didn't do anything. So let's start this. You see how close she was? That's an easy hit. That's an easy gold card. But what are you both doing? You're just farming. You're making the lane passive. No, you gotta make sure you can get your opponent as low as possible.
Okay.
So you can make her back off or you can go in for the kill. So let's talk about this one as well. All right, so she backs off and I'm gonna play again. She ate your Q again. All right, so the spear missed. Now you know where Nidalee is. It gives you information. Now at this point, did you ping your opponent?
I believe so. No?
Okay. The moment you saw a spear, you should have pinged here. So it gives your teammates information that Nidalee's there.
Okay.
Because in League, this is a we strive on communication. Who can, you know, the team with the most information on the enemy team will win the game. So if you ping here, bottom lane knows, okay, Nidalee's around there, this area. Aurelion Sol on top lane will say, okay, so Nidalee's bot side. So I'm safe. You know what I mean?
Yeah.
Okay, so this is the part where we come in trades. Syndra's going to trade with you right here. Alright, so she didn't stun you. You throw the gold card. There you go, throw the Q, auto attack. You're going to back off since she's seen Nidalee. Alright, now look at her HP. Look how low she is compared to you. But why are you backing off is because you have no...
Vision.
No, mana.
Mana. Oh.
Okay, see, now when we're talking about mid lane, I always tell everyone it's all about conserving your mana. Mana control. You gotta learn how to not just use your mana while you have it. It's not a race to get it to zero. No. You need to conserve your mana. When you're playing Twisted Fate, have at least more than 40% of your mana. And what can keep you getting mana is your blue card. Yes. So let's talk about this one. Okay, so Nidalee's in lane. She healed him. All right, so when you're low at this point, 43, and your pick a card is 40. All right, so let's see here. So you warded both sides. That's good. You throw a blue card. You're going to focus on hitting it. Let's just put the camera on manual. All right, so we're gonna see. Okay, so there's a blue card now again. All right, so she got really close. At least when she gets really close, you have to land, you have to auto attack her.
Okay,
it's with your pick a card. So we're gonna rewind back this, what you could have done here. So let's see here, this one, there you go. You see how close she is, and you had pick a card. You could have landed an auto attack on her before she pushed you. You're allowing her to harass you without trading back. So let's take a look at this one. All right, so you got slowed here. So you're going to pick a blue card. You're going to throw it. You're going to gain mana back. Let's see here. We're going to talk about this one. Does she get hit? Most likely, I think she did. Yeah, she did. Okay. So look how low she is.
Yeah.
Okay, so look how low she is. Okay, let's talk about it. You still have Thunderlords. You have Ignite, and you have your your stack deck. So let's do it all together. Okay, let's do some math here. Syndra's that low since she ate your Q. She's at 300 HP. Your stack deck will deal 75 damage plus a gold card, which is 95 damage. So that's about 160 damage. Plus your ignite, which adds 130 damage. That's 290 damage. Plus your Q, which is 130 damage. So you're about doing 450 damage to her with Thunderlords. You see how that's an easy kill right now?
Yeah.
That's why you gotta estimate how much damage you're doing to your target. You gotta think in your mind, alright, Sintra's that low, and I got my stack deck ready. I have Thunderlords as well. And I have Ignite. What can I do? That's an easy kill. Because she looks like she's going in, so let's play this out. Alright, so you use your stack deck, so we're gonna see again. Alright, so you're gonna blue card that one. You have mana. She has no more potions. You're missing out kill and get a throw. Okay, so you see it there. You threw a red card. You're using your mana again. And you see how much damage she's taking from your minions?
Yeah.
Do you see how much of an easy kill this is?
Yeah.
There you go. You're missing. This is why. There you go. See, why are you so scared of her if she's the lower health? Correct?
Yeah.
See, there you go. See, this is why I want you to visualize. When it's in the laning phase, we all want to take advantage of our opponent. We want to see their weakness, and we want to see what plays we can make at this state. Level 4, easy kill. Now, you have to press tap. Does she have any potions left?
No.
Do you have a potion?
Yes.
There you go. And what do you see? Does she have minions around her?
My minions.
Yeah. No. Okay. Does she have minions around her?
No.
Do you have... Yes. Do you have Flash Ignite?
Yeah.
There you go. See, these are the things you have to take note of. It's not just about laning phase, about your whoever gets level 6 first or whoever builds items first. It's the one who can get ahead first. So,
okay.
All right, so let's play this one. Because you're underestimating your damage. All right, so look at it again. All right, she's level 5. You have your stack deck. You're see how you're pushing the lane, forcing her to go back? You're forcing her under her tower. You're making her play safe under her tower. That's why I tell you, try to freeze your lane as much, so when she commits with that kind of HP, who's going to get the kill?
Me.
There you go. You're going to get the kill. All right, so yeah. So this is the first thing, the mistake I see, is that you're both playing passive. No, it's the one who can dominate the lane. Alright, so at this point, you lost an opportunity for a kill, but you still have lane dominance. So she's forced to go back. Yeah, she's backing off. Alright, so you're going to throw... Okay, so there's a gold card. We got to make sure it's a blue card. Always a blue card when you're farming lane. Alright, so Syndra was that low. Do you think she's going to stay?
No.
No. Okay, so let's talk about this. When their mid laner is gone, what are you going to do?
Push the lane as fast as I can so she misses CS.
Yes, there you go. You push your CS and then you back as the lane resets.
Yeah.
Because the moment you push this, your minions are going to get killed by tower and then the lane is going to reset back into the middle. And then you're in a CS lead. You will be a CS lead from there. All right, so let's take a look at this. She decided to stay. All right.
Yeah.
She decided to stay, but the reason why she went back is, do you have mana?
No,
you don't. Okay, so let's take a look at your mana. You have enough for a W, which is 40 mana. You have 40 mana here. Do you think this is an easy kill?
Yes.
Okay, so we can see that. But you're going to miss out on this one.
Yeah, she was playing too passive.
No. She wasn't playing too passive. She was playing too risky, but you were playing too passive. She was playing safe, but in a risky... She wasn't playing safe enough. The reason why she stayed as well is because you're not playing aggressive. You're playing passive. This is why it all becomes in mid lane mind games. She's not the one being passive. You are. You see what I'm getting at?
Yeah.
So there you go. So yeah. So it's not your opponent. It's you. She's back here. Like, do you think this is an easy gold card flash auto kill?
Yeah.
It ignite? Yeah, of course it is. Yeah, so that's why I want you to pay attention with your stack deck as well. Your stack deck on top of a pick a card, you do massive amounts of damage. So take a note on that, all right?
Okay.
All right, so let's So let's skip this. Oh, okay. So that was a questionable flash, but okay, so you ignited her. But alright, so let's talk about this one. Alright. Alright, so Lee Sin's gonna gank middle because Syndra decided to stay. Yeah. Now think about it. You flashed? Okay, so let's talk about the flash mechanics here. Was that necessary?
No.
Could you have done that earlier?
Yeah.
There you go. Now, I don't think you got any kill credit out of this one. There. You didn't get any kill credit. You didn't get any assist. So that flash wasn't worth it. You see how? See, you see how that 400 gold could have been yours?
Yeah.
All right. So, now I want you to also focus on... Let's talk about this one. When Lee Sin came here. All right. So... The first thing is Syndra flashed, all right? So whenever Syndra flashed and you flash, keep in mind as well. My flash will be up when Syndra flashes, when Syndra's flashes up. All right?
Yeah.
And if you didn't flash and Felicia she flashed, try to make a timer on it or type in chat, "Okay guys, Syndra flashed." Flash is always on a 5-minute cooldown, so you can tell yourself, "Okay, she flashed at 5 minutes, her flash will be up 10 minutes." Always keep that in mind as well. There's a lot of things you have to keep up when you're playing mid lane because it's super important to dominate your lane.
Yeah.
Okay. So, of course, I want a question about this as well. There you go. You stun her, but the ignite was unnecessary. The ignite was unnecessary because Lee Sin tower dove and he couldn't follow up. Now, you have no summoners. This is why we have to be careful of the summoners we're going to use. If you're not going to use your summoners properly, you're going to lose the lane.
Okay.
Okay, so you have no summoners anymore. Syndra still has her ignite. So that's something you have to be aware of. And of course, there you go. She's... Oh, did you... Oh, okay, so you got her kill. Okay. Oh, you got... Okay, so you got the stack deck as she flashed. Okay, so that's good. I didn't foresee this. I thought you backed off and she actually got away, but she got killed. So, all right, so you got something out of there. I didn't foresee that. Let me take a look at it again. So that was my accident. Yeah, you auto-attacked her as she flashed. Okay, so the auto-attack went off. So, okay, so there was some credit there for... There was credit there for the ignite, but there was no credit for a flash.
The flash, yeah.
So, okay, so... Alright. Alright, so you're gonna push a lane here.
We have a quick question.
Yes.
Would Deathfire Touch be better on Twisted Fate, or is Thunderlords still better?
Thunderlords. Why? Is because, did you know that if you use your stack deck... Okay, so it requires 3 auto-attacks to proc Thunderlords, correct?
Yeah.
Did you know your stack deck and your auto counts as 2?
No, I did not know that.
So, for example, you picked a card and you had stack deck. You throw it, followed up with a Q, that procs Thunderlords. Because the reason why is Thunderlords count... procs on abilities and an auto. Your stacked deck counts as both because you're dealing damage with an auto and you're dealing damage with an ability. So that counts as 2. So 2 autos with a stacked deck and 1 auto counts as a Thunderlords.
Okay.
Yeah, so yeah. So Thunderlords is good on Twisted Fate, not Deathfire's Touch. Don't think about that. Deathfire's Touch is only good with Brand, Zyra, or Malzahar.
Okay.
Yeah, so let's see here. All right, so that's a smart option. You get a Sheen, you get Boots, you get a couple of Biscuits. Awesome! Pink Ward! Good, good, good. You got a Pink Ward. That's the main focus right here. You are buying wards with the money you have. You're being a team player. That's good. All right, so laning phase could be a work on. Just remember, when you see an opportunity, take it, all right? That's what I want you to do. Alright, so let's see what you did here. Alright, so let's talk about level 6. Okay, so you're level 6. What does Twisted Fate have when you're level 6?
Map pressure.
Map pressure. He is the one who focuses on the map and makes sure he can gank a lane successfully with a gold card and, of course, help the other lane. So we're going to talk about using the ultimate. So we're going to... Alright, so you're going to clear a ward here. You decide to place a pink ward here. And... place a ward there for safety. That's very nice. See, you may be a bronze player, but you're warding great. You're giving your teammates vision. That's something I don't need to tell you anymore because you already have it down. That's great. That's good. So we don't have to focus on the warding right now. All right. So there. Syndra decided to ward here. Stun. Ooh. Okay, there you go. Stun. Okay, so you have to back up because you see... Okay, that was a... pretty weird card here. Okay, so you're gonna get speared and Nidalee's gonna jump on you. Nope. Okay, Lee Sin's here. Does Syndra commit? No. She missed her stun. There you go. There's a kill. Alright, so you're gonna get another kill here with a gold. Ooh my god, almost. Throw. Okay, awesome. There you go. Alright. Alright, so you're gonna push the lane pretty hard here. Gonna push the lane pretty hard here. Now, once you push a lane and you already see that two of the jungler and mid laner died, what do you do as Twisted Fate? You push the lane. Yes, you push the lane. Since you're pushing the lane, look for a gank. Okay, let's look at top lane. Aurelion Sol is dying. But I know once you get up there, he may be dead already. But yeah. Look how low is Teemo. Now think about bot lane. Okay, bot lane, we can't gank because bot lane is pushing. So we see an opportunity top lane. But at the same time, look at your mana. So when I'm talking about mana management here, okay, let's talk. Destiny's 150. So bringing you down to 125. Pick a card is 40. And wild cards is 90. So that's 130 plus 150. That's 280. That's enough for a gank. Understand?
Yeah.
That's why you have to always focus on your mana. So let's take a look here. Okay, so Aurelion Sol died. Now look at you doing. Now what I see top lane. What happened at top?
Teemo killed Aurelion Sol.
And how low is he?
Really low.
Do you think that's an opportunity to gank?
Yes.
Yes, there you go. But the problem is, you keep
pushing mid.
Pushing it. It's not bad pushing middle, but when you're playing Twisted Fate, you want to use him at its fullest. You're not using Twisted Fate at its fullest. If you're playing another mid lane champion, such as like Ahri, Victor, or Orianna, there's no way for you to gank top, correct? So this would be the correct way of pushing middle, pressuring middle. But since you're Twisted Fate, you got to learn how to open up your map awareness and see where can I go to get a kill.
Okay.
Alright. Okay, so you find... Okay. Alright, okay, so that's really bad. You activated your ultimate. And, okay, there you go. Finally, you finally...
I got the wrong part.
Oh, no! Alright. Okay, so let's talk about this one. Alright. I want you to take a look at this one where... okay, so at this point, you spotted him. Very low. I'm proud of that. So, I didn't know you were going to gank, but the problem is that you activated your ultimate too early.
Okay.
Because look at this one. I want to take a look at top lane. What happened here?
He saw it and then he tried.
There. No. Someone's pinging him back. Because they saw you going up now. And they saw that your ultimate's active. Next time when you use your ultimate when you're ready to teleport.
Okay.
Don't delay it. So Teemo won't likely know that you're coming up there, or he'll just be an instant, right? Don't just use your ultimate and be like, okay, I'm gonna wait another 2 to 3 seconds to teleport, because once they do that, the teammate will realize that they're in danger.
Okay.
Okay. So here, all right. So the magic blue card. Woo!
I thought I was a little like 1 second.
A little slow. Yes.
Yeah.
That's fine. All right, so you didn't get anything out of top lane, right? So you're gonna go back. Okay, so you're gonna go back. You're gonna get your. All right, so you get cooldown reduction boots. Okay, that's completely fine. Getting boots first is completely fine as TF. It's very optional, situational. But let me see how much gold you actually had before you bought the boots. 820. You could have, okay, instead of the boots, I could have, you should have built an Essence Wisp, I believe. It's the one that builds into a Lich Bane. You know the one that gives 5%?
Aether Wisp, yeah.
Yeah, Aether Wisp, there you go. Yeah, Aether Wisp, thank you. It gives you 5% movement speed and ability power. That's, even though the boots give you cooldown reduction, at least we're trying to amplify your magic damage.
Okay.
Right now, you're supposed to be killing your opponent. Some people rush boots first on Twisted Fate, especially the cooldown reduction boots. That's completely fine. But try to get your Lich Bane as fast as possible to pour out more damage.
Okay.
Alright, so let's see here. Alright, so the first things first is that we know that Syndra killed someone. Okay.
Aurelion
Sol,
top lane, yeah.
So he killed Aurelion Sol. Now it gives you information. Alright, where's their mid laner?
Top lane.
Top lane. What am I going to do since my ultimate's down?
Push mid.
There you go. Awesome. And also, make sure to ward. Don't ever forget to ward.
Okay.
Alright, so... Let's see here. Alright, so you ward. Good. Now, you're just standing there. Okay, so you're gonna push the lane. Alright, so Syndra... Oh, okay. Syndra's back here. Alright, so... Alright, so Syndra's back here. We're gonna... Let's see how the lane shoves now. Alright, so your team is wanting to do dragon. You're slowly pushing the lane. Alright, so let's talk about this one. Alright, so let's talk about this one. I want to go this over as well. When you're farming with your Q, I want you to actually try farming and hitting the champion at the same time.
Okay.
Alright, so we're going to be controlling your mana. What happens if I use my Q to farm minions and hit a champion? That's completely worth than just using it to farm minions, correct?
Yeah.
Yeah, there you go. Alright, so we're going to keep playing this one. Alright, so we're going to keep going. Alright, so you're pinging missing middle. Alright, so you're pushing your lane. Alright. So you got pushed back. We're going to see what happens here. Alright, so you want to... Okay, so is Lee Sin going to give you blue? Are you going to go to blue? No, you're not going to blue. Alright, so you're going to keep pushing the lane. Alright, Syndra's missing. There you go, you're pushing lane. Alright, so Syndra's back here with Nidalee. Alright, so the first thing you saw is that they're pinging you to they want to get mid lane. Alright, so she flashed. And she's gonna dive with an ult. Okay. So let's talk about mana management again. Do you have mana?
No.
Is that necessary?
No.
No. Okay, that's why less red cards, less gold cards, more blue cards. When you're throwing your Q, you always want to follow up with a blue card to restore the mana that you lost.
Okay.
More blue cards. Throw a red card if you want to harass the opponent, or throw a gold card if you want to connect it with a Q. That's why I want to see more. And in lane, don't be scared to play aggressive when you have your stacked deck. Don't just use your stacked deck, which is your E, to farm minions. No, use it to trade with a champion.
Okay.
Alright, so that's what I want you to do most. Alright, so... So you're out of mana. You're going top lane. Okay, so you're going to gank Teemo here. Let's take a look at this one.
I decided not to go in because I didn't have enough mana for my ult.
You don't have enough mana.
Yeah.
Now see, imagine if you did have mana. See?
Yeah.
Where we're getting at? Alright. So Syndra's missing. Somebody's pinging him that he's gone or it's you. Alright, so we're going to see what you bid. Okay, so you get an Aether Wisp. You go back to mid lane. Alright, so she's trading with you. You're farming. Blue card. There you go. Farming with your Q. There you go. Good auto. Alright, so... We're gonna skim through this one. Alright, so she has a blue buff. Alright, so she's harassing you. She's trying to trade with you. Alright, so we're gonna see what you do here. Now let's take a look again. Alright, let's take a look. Every time your ultimate is up, you gotta look around the map. You gotta keep using your ultimate. Don't let it go to waste. Okay, my ultimate's up. What I see that can be gankable. Okay, there's no way I'm going to gank bottom. They're over-pushing. Is there a reason for me to go top lane? Maybe Lee Sin can help me out to kill Nidalee. You see that?
Yeah.
That's why I want you, when you're playing with Twisted Fate, the moment you see your ultimate come up, look around the map. But of course, look at yourself as well before you look around the map. You don't want to get killed while teleporting somewhere. A lot of people have done that, where they activate their ulti, and as they're teleporting, they don't focus themselves, and you're dead. So you gotta be careful of that too. Alright, so here you're playing super passive here. Alright, so you put a ward here. Very nice. Alright, okay. So finally, okay, you see bot lane is gankable since they're pushing. Okay, so I wanna actually rewind this one. Look at yourself. I want you to take a look at yourself. Let's speed this up a bit. Alright, so you're paying attention at bot lane. There you go. So you activate your ulti and you're teleporting. Okay, I want you to pick a card as you teleport. Did you know you could do that?
Yeah.
Alright, so while you're teleporting, you want to be at your gold card already. Not as when you teleported here. Let me take a look at this one here. Alright, so you're gonna teleport here. You see how you're delaying while you're picking your card? See, as you teleport, you should already have your gold card ready.
Okay.
For instance, then, because when you're picking a card as you teleport, you're wasting time, you're wasting an opportunity, you're wasting a moment to stun the enemy. And that can count as a loss right there because it's too late to save a teammate. Imagine if Corki died here because you didn't pull out a gold card. It can be his fault for getting caught as well, but it can be also your problem because you didn't have it ready by then. You know what I mean? Alright, so yeah, always pick your gold card before you teleport.
Yeah, okay.
Alright, so Syndra is missing right now. Alright, so you're gonna go back middle. Alright, so you're gonna go back middle here. You found an opportunity to use your ulti. Alright, so Syndra is missing. You're pinging that she is gone. Alright, so we're gonna skim through this one. I want to take a look at this one as well when we're talking about cooldowns. I want to go over you how important it is to commit to somebody who used their spell. Alright, so we're going to take a look at this one. I want you to take a look at this one. Alright, what did Syndra just use?
Her stun.
Her stun. Did it stun you?
No.
Once it doesn't stun you, commit to her.
Okay.
Punisher, okay, Syndra, you didn't stun me, you're vulnerable to my attack. I'm gonna try to gold card you, or blue card you, or red card you. You gotta trade in on that. Once an opponent misses their stun, their bind, their engage, punish them. That's why I want you to take a look at that. Okay, Syndra missed their stun, I got an opportunity to...
Excuse me, can you repeat that again? Sorry,
Syndra missed their stun. I have an opportunity to...
To engage.
But what are you doing? You're running back. That's why. So you gotta be careful. Okay. At this situation, instead of running back, try running to a side. Because Syndra's stun is straight. Of course you don't want to run straight. You want to dodge it. If you dodge to the side, you will be already near her. Ready for a gold card.
Okay.
So, alright, so that's why I want you to focus on. Because when you play passive like this, you're allowing her to get her cooldowns back. You know what I mean? Did you use your stun yet?
No.
Did she use her stun yet?
Yes.
There you go. That's why I want you to also focus on. Alright, so we're going to see a blue card here. Alright, so you're going to miss 2CS here. Alright. Alright, so you got to... Alright, there you go. She gets hit again. Alright. She used her stun. Okay, I want to talk about this one. She stunned you, but she's overly committing. Do you think this is a kill potential for you?
Yes.
Yes. Awesome. Why? Is because you have Ignite. She has Ignite as well, but she already stunned you and used majority of her damage. Let's see what happens here. Let's take a close at it. This looks like a kill potential because you have your...
Stun. And Ignite.
Stun, Ignite, and...
My stack deck.
Your stack deck. Important. Is the stack deck. Okay, so let's take a look at this one. What are you doing?
Running away.
Running away. You're allowing her to commit at you. Alright, so you finally throw a stun, but you're dead. Because why? You allowed her to poke you without returning fire. So I want to take a look at this one. Alright, so we're gonna take a look at this slowly. Alright, so you throw a blue card here. I'm gonna slow down to the part if I was in your... Okay, she stunned you, okay? So, you see that one? What did she just do? She just autoed a minion. We're gonna look at this slowly. Look at you. Running away. You see that?
Yeah.
You see yourself running away. And look, you didn't even activate your W. You see how much delay there is? Imagine if you activate your W after you got out of stun. Then maybe you could have picked your gold card quicker. Stun her, Q her, Ignite. She dies with a Thunderlord proc as well. But if you watch yourself slowly, you're already running away. And see, you didn't even activate your pick a card yet. This is a glitch. This is your pick a card is up. Alright, so, and then there you go. We're still buying time. And see how you finally press W after receiving all that damage?
Yes.
Your pick a card was up. This is just a spectator glitch. It's always been up because you never used it. So, Imagine if you pick the card without running. You know what I mean?
Yeah.
But you were already scared. So you were scared and you allowed her to
engage on me and poke me down.
Mm-hmm. So finally, yeah, see, you finally commit after you press W. Why couldn't you press your pick a card a lot earlier, correct?
Yeah.
See, okay, so I wanna rewind this one as well. Alright, so we're gonna take a look at this one as you threw your card. Alright, so she was low at this one. You had your stacked deck. Alright, so she stuns you here, she pokes you out. I wanna take a look at this one where you threw an auto attack as you pick gold card. Okay, you only autoed. You didn't throw the gold card. You were dead regardless. But just look at your health, look at her health, and look how much the stack deck did. Look at this one. How much damage did that do?
A lot.
Imagine it with a gold card, and imagine it with a Q. Is she dead?
Yeah.
Yes, she is. That's why you gotta think two steps ahead of yourself. I can beat her. I'm just scared. I need to remove that. But of course, there's a difference between playing scared and playing defense or playing safe. You're playing scared. You're not playing safe. You're playing scared. They're two different things. So I want you to take note of what happened here. You see how when you delay your pick a card, things can go wrong?
Yes.
Awesome. Okay, I just want you to see that. So you missed a kill opportunity there. So we're going to skim through this one. All right, so you finally have your Lich Bane, right? Okay. All right, so let's take a look at this one. Let's take a look at this one. All right, so when you're level 11, I want you to buy the blue totem, all right?
Okay.
The blue totem. The blue totem is important. So let's see where you stand here. All right, so... All right, there you go. I want to take a look at this. What did you just do?
I flashed.
Alright, before you flash, maybe if Teemo was alone, maybe you could have caught up. But who's there?
Syndra.
You can't be too greedy on yourself. I understand there's a lot of things in Bronze where we prioritize kills more than anything. In Bronze, I've spectated some Bronze games, people fight over kills more than anything. More than objectives, more than warding control, more than Baron, more than Dragon. They just want kills. And then they get so pissed that they have 30,000 kills, but they lost the game. Because you didn't use those kills to push for objectives. And here, it looks like you're being greedy for a Teemo kill. And you were so tunneled on Syndra. So tunneled on Teemo that you didn't spot Syndra. This is why we're talking about tunnel vision. You can't always tunnel vision. You gotta look around your opponents. Okay, Teemo's this low, but is there somebody else there that I have to be cautious about?
Yes, Syndra,
there you go. Okay, so, there you go. And then, so, was your flash worth it?
No.
Of course not. There you go. So, okay, so Syndra ignited you, but she doesn't. You stunned her, you ran away.
She could have killed me there. She had her ult up.
You stunned her, and she was too far from you.
No, like, if you rewind a bit, I think she could have killed me because she stunned me on the tower, and I think she could have killed me there.
Let's take a look at this again. Okay, so you flashed here. Yeah, I think you're right. Let's see here. No, I think her ultimate was still down from the last time she killed you.
Oh, okay.
I don't know. This is spectator bug. I can't see it live. All right, so she stunned you here. She ignited you here. Yeah, I don't think she had her ulti up from just looking at it. I think you could have died as well if she ulted you, but I don't think it was up. And this is too far for her to ult you. So, alright, so we're gonna skim through this one. Yeah, her ultimate was down. Yeah, it was down. Alright, so let's take a look at this one. You're playing in a danger zone. If Syndra stuns you, what's gonna happen?
I'm gonna die.
You're gonna die. So this is why it's very safe here. I wanna take a look at this one. Did you back? No, you're not backing. You're playing. See, okay. You know who you're acting like right now?
Like Syndra from the beginning?
Yes! There you go! Good, good, good. See, you even spot out yourself. You're being Syndra, just like what she did to you at the beginning. Who's playing passive now?
Her?
Okay, no. Okay, now, you're still playing passive, but what is she doing?
She's pushing.
Playing aggressive, so she can catch you. because she knows that she can burst you down now. She knows that she can tower dive because she might just throw ulti, you die, she can just walk away from the tower. She might. Okay, so we're gonna skip this part. Okay. There you go. This is your punishment. And ulti. See? You see what she did? She did something you could have done to her in the
beginning.
See, we always make these mistakes. That's why I want you to take a look at it so we can review and you can see what's happening. This doesn't apply to Twisted Fate. This can apply to any champion. Whether you have the burst, you gotta just calculate in my mind, okay, Syndra is this low. Maybe I can beat her. Let's try for it. Oh, I could. I had my Thunderlords up. I had my Ignite up. I had my stack deck. I had my charm. I had my stun. I had whatever. You know what I mean?
Yeah.
So I want to take a look at that. So she punished you because she did something you didn't do in the beginning of the game. So, all right. So let's take a look at this as well. Let me guess. Next item. Okay, so we're going to talk about next item. You're being punished by an AP jungler and an AP mid laner who can do burst. What do you think is a better item than a needlessly large rod?
Abyssal Scepter.
There you go. Bingo. Why? Because it gives you...
magic resist.
Awesome. And it gives you as well...
AP.
There you go. Awesome. There you go. And it also reduces their magic ability power so you can do more damage.
Yeah.
So, okay. So let's take a look here. Alright, so we're gonna skim through this one. Skim. Alright, so you're gonna push middle since Syndra's missing. Rulian is with you. Alright, so, oops, accidentally pressed. Alright, so we're gonna take a look at this one. Skim. Alright, so you push mid lane. Now people are pinging tower. There's a pink ward here. Alright, so you got a vision of them. So Syndra and Nidalee was there. Alright, so first things first, let's take a look. The whole enemy is missing. You spot a squishy Nidalee. So Nidalee's still squishy. Did you know with your build, you can actually 100 to 0 her at this hit rate?
Not at the time, no.
Okay, so let's just understand damage, okay? So okay. Nidalee, 35 magic resist. Let's just, for example, you had an Abyssal, or you didn't have Abyssal, you had the... Okay, let's just go with your build right now. So we're going to do some math here, and this is why I want you to estimate how much damage can Twisted Fate do. All right, so E, your stack deck deals 140 damage, plus a gold card, which is 180, 210, so... this is about like 400, okay? We'll just estimate 300, 400. 400 plus 270s, I'm so dumb. 650. No. 750 damage. 750 damage with Ignite is 270 true damage, so you're dealing almost 1,000 damage, and also don't forget your Thunderlords, and also don't forget...
my stack deck. Oh, my Lich Bane.
You're a Lich Bane. You already completed a Lich Bane. So you can deal over 1,000 damage. Now, they have magic resist, yes. But this is something you can easily kill because you're going to land an auto, you're going to land a stun, throw your stack deck, and then another auto. Do you think that could have finished a squishy Nidalee off?
Yeah.
And how many levels are you above Nidalee?
Three, I believe.
Three. She's level 8, you're level 11. That's where you got to see... you gotta estimate how much damage you can do. Because people underestimate the damage. They keep doubting, I'm so behind. No, you're still ahead. Even though you died to Syndra 2 times, you're still ahead of their jungler. That's why I want you to take a look at, alright?
Okay.
So you gotta estimate your damage, and that's how we're gonna win. Alright, so there's a teleport here. Alright, so let's take a look here. Alright, so we're gonna see the slow motion and we're gonna go through what happened here and how you could have made a change, alright? So we're gonna go through this one. That's a wonderful ulti. You didn't have your stack deck because your gold card expired or you already used it. You're trying to see who to focus. Okay, out of this whole area, who do you think you could kill?
Probably either Teemo or Kog'Maw.
Teemo, Kog'Maw, and what you have to be careful as well.
Syndra.
Syndra, okay? So Lee Sin was behind, but I'm pretty sure you weren't paying attention. You're always paying attention to your opponents you're going to deal with. All right, so looking at your stack deck, it was down. All right, so Syndra threw a Q here. You throw a QS here. All right, so I want to talk about this one as well. How you throw your cards, were you focusing Kog'Ma?
No.
No, you were focusing Leona. How you threw the card at her, because how when you throw a card, you're not looking at the two cards that are being thrown on the side. You're looking at the main card. Now, yeah. The question is here, why are you focusing the tank?
At the time, I lagged a bit, and the dragon was still up for a second, so I was trying to...
Okay, so you're trying to buy time. Okay, so your pick a card is up. Who's attacking you?
Kog'Ma.
Kog'Ma. All right, so let's take a look at this slow play. Lee Sin's on the side. You're running away. Let's push this one a little bit more. See that gold card? Okay, so we got a gold card. Let's see how you use it. Oh, you're dead anyway.
Yeah.
Oh, okay. So I wanna take a look at this one. See, look at this one again. Alright, so let's take a look again. Let's take a look. We're gonna slow down here. Alright. So you got your stack deck, no, that's your pick a card. Okay, so you had Lich Bane, a gold card, and a Q. What happened to Syndra? Watch what happens to Syndra. Oh wait, did she die? No, she got a gold. Oh, okay, so she's alive. I thought you killed her. Okay, so you got your stack deck up. I thought you killed her. I'm like, that's a lot of damage. I don't think you have killed her, but she just went to the fog of war. But what happened here was, I want to take a look back at what happened here. All right, so let's go to when Dragon first started. This is the biggest mistake I've seen. All right. You chose a card while hitting Dragon. The reason why you don't want to use your pick a card is because there's a better moment to choose to use that spell than instead of hitting Dragon with it. Because the moment your support put Spooky Ghost out, they're already about to commit. And you already chose a card. Now, this is what happened. You delayed the card. You see how in this point here, you still have your card up?
Yeah.
Did you ever use it?
No.
And now it's going to be locked on... Now it's not going to be on cooldown yet because you keep holding it. And at this point, you never used it. Guess what happens? It finally goes on cooldown. You see that?
Yeah.
See, it finally goes on cooldown because you never used the card. And what did that... What happened there? It costed you that fight because it's still on cooldown. You could have maybe hit Kog'Ma with it. Kog'Ma is a 100 to 0. He has only 1,000 health, barely any magic resist. You had Lich Bane, you had your Q, you had your W. Maybe stack deck was a bit delayed here, but this is what happens when you don't learn how to use your abilities correctly. So, alright, so we're going to skip to this one. Alright, so let's skim through this one. Alright, so let's see what you build here. Whoa, you didn't buy anything. Alright. Oh! Jesus Christ. Okay, so let's take a look at this one. Alright, so you were pissed at Syndra, so you came back to kill her. Alright, so let's take a look. She has 700 HP. We're gonna look at this slowly. 700 HP, she has 65 magic resist because of Chalice, because of the Athene's Unholy Grail. So let's take a look at this one. Let's look at how much damage you had. You didn't even have your stack card ready. Oh wait, did you? No, that's pick a card. Alright, so take a look. You got a gold card off, and you stunned her as she stunned you. Look how much damage that did. That did a lot because of your Lich Bane. You decided to throw a Q, ignite, and look at that. Look how much damage you can do to her. She had 700 HP. Imagine you doing that to people with 1,000 HP with lesser magic resist. Correct?
Yes.
All right, so that's why I want you to focus that. Don't underestimate your damage with a stacked deck. It hurts a lot. It does so much damage. All right, so I'm going to skim through this one. You're very low. All right, so it looks like here you're buying Ludens Echo. That's a common second item. All right, so you got a kill here. Let's take a look here. Your ultimate is still on cooldown. Wait, what happened here?
Oh, because we found Syndra.
And my thing broke. It's not pausing anymore. No! Why it break? Alright, so we're gonna just look at slow motion. Yeah, okay, so you cut out Syndra here. Yeah, and stun. Alright, so you instantly throw a gold card. Okay, so you're gonna back clear, you're gonna get a Luden Seco. Yeah, okay, so you got your Luden Seco. Let's see your fourth item.
Oh, right here, I was doing my bed, so I'm just gonna be standing there for like a few seconds.
Mm-hmm. Alright, so let's take a look here. Alright, so you're gonna keep pushing, you're gonna keep pushing. Alright, you're gonna clear that, get three minions. Alright, now. Alright, so you see Nidalee alone here. What do you see bot lane?
Syndra, Kog'Maw, and Leona.
Okay, what do you see top lane?
No one.
No one. Okay, no one's top lane. You know what you could have done instead of going mid lane? Go top lane. Why? Is there anything else you can get mid lane?
No.
No. Do you see something you can get top lane?
The tower.
The tower. Objectives. You always want objective control. Because you're just wasting your time at middle, getting nothing. Alright, so you decide to go bottom and helping them out. Let's see what happened here. Alright, so let's see what happened here. He's gonna die. Let's see how you use this one. You got a gold card out. Okay, that was a little... Okay. Stun, Q, ignite, and stack card. There you go. But, okay, so I want to question this a little bit. This is why you have to learn how to use your ultimate properly and, of course, your spells. Okay, so let's take a look at this one. You walk back. You see that?
Yeah.
That could have been instantly thrown at Syndra as she flashed. So that was a waste of a summoner spell there because of your walking back. You walked back. So just remember, once you ulti, you gotta target Syndra instantly.
Okay.
It looks like here that you right-clicked here as you teleported. So we're gonna have to fix on that, alright?
Okay.
Alright, so that's another mistake because you could have saved Flash there for a better use. Because summoner spells, especially when it comes to 25 minutes and above, is important. Especially for Twisted Fate. You gotta have to learn how to flash stun and save your flash at a best time. So okay, so you're gonna take blue buff here. Let's see here. Alright, so this is playing a little bit greedy here. Alright, so...
I was just making sure that they didn't really try to engage on me.
Mm-hmm. It's best to stay with your teammate, but also make the better call. If you need to go back, just go back.
Okay.
And your teammate will back off as well. So, let's see here. Alright, so we all know where three of them are. We have complete information about them. You're going to be pushing middle, pressuring it. Let's see what you did here. Alright, so let's talk about it. We know Nidalee's around here. Alright, so we don't know if this is warded. Alright, so there's Syndra there. Alright, so you guys do dragon again. Awesome. Alright, so Teemo's top lane. We all know that Teemo's top lane. Aurelion is teleporting top. Alright, so let's talk about this one. You see how you're pushing in the fog of war?
Yeah.
Who's with you? Only a Corki. Where's your support? Lee Sin and Syndra are back down here. And look how far you're pushing. Now, you can be punished here or you could not. This is such a random ulti here. I mean, it's a random package, but the point is, you're pushing so far without vision, and your enemy team can easily kill both of you. Because do we see any of them around the map?
No.
No.
It's
okay.
Just Teemo top.
Yeah, only Teemo top. Of course, Teemo is split pushing, so four of them can easily come kill you. You don't know if they're right here. You don't know if they're right here. You don't know if they're also here as well, because Karma and Lee Sin aren't with you. So, alright, so we're gonna skin that, alright. Oh! Alright, see? Talking about this, what happened here?
Syndra came up from behind us.
See, Syndra came up behind y'all, okay, Corki finished her, but like I said, there was no vision around
here.
See? If the whole enemy team followed up, both of you could have died. So, that's why I want you to take a note on that. Don't push without wards, or don't push without your teammates. So, we're gonna skin through this. Okay, looks like here you're going for Zhonya's, correct?
Yes.
Alright, so first thing, you have two cloth armor. Alright, so you bought two cloth armors, which is pretty random. That was the I think that was actually the old build of Seeker's Arm Guard. Now it's just one armor cloth instead
no,
of two.
It's two.
It's two?
Yeah.
No.
Yeah.
What? No, Seeker's Arm. No, wait, I'm wrong.
Yeah, they changed. At first it was just one cloth armor and one amber
fangs. Oh, it's two! Wow.
Yeah.
Oh, I thought it was the other way around. Wow. Okay. You know why? Because I buy Seeker's Arm Guard instantly. I don't buy the components for it. Wow. I'm wrong. Okay. So you got me there. You should be coaching me. All right. So let's talk about this one as well. You're standing there. Syndra, I don't know if she ulted. Standing here again. I don't know what you're doing here. I'm not gonna question this one.
I don't remember either.
Maybe you're on Facebook talking to your girlfriend or something.
she was on League, I think. She's on a different.
I'm just playing around. But here, this was very awkward. Alright, so here you got punished here. Look at that damage. That's a lot of damage.
Yeah.
And I think. And. Okay, so she didn't ulti you. Alright, so. Magma Flash. No! Alright, so see, you died here. That was very questionable that she did that. I'm not gonna see what's happening here, but yeah, see, okay, so you died here, alright? So that was completely your fault for
yeah.
doing something, okay? So alright, so your team kind of won that fight. We're gonna skim through it. Alright, so you're dead. Now let's take a look. Is your ultimate up?
Yes.
Yes, it is. Okay, so let's try to find something what we can do here. Alright, so your team doesn't really have any wards around, just up here, nothing down here. Your whole team is missing. So alright. First things first. No, okay. They may Baron, but okay. So the first thing is that you see a Leona there. What's up for you?
Blue buff.
Now also it's very dangerous that it's not warded at the same time. Look at the route you're going. You're going to Baron. Imagine taking this route, correct?
Yeah.
Instead of here. Imagine if they were here. Imagine if they were there. You wouldn't know because you're face checking.
Yeah.
Face checking. That's bad. Bad, bad, bad. Never face check. And also, like I said, buy the blue totem ward. When you hit level 9, don't forget about the blue trinket.
Yeah.
Alright, so that's what I want you to get. Alright, so.
It's just sometimes I don't switch it because my teammates usually don't ward, so I just. Think that having two wards?
No. Did you know that the blue trinket wards and it's last forever until found?
Yeah.
That's why I want you to get it. And the greatest thing about blue trinket is that you don't have to be close to a bush to use it.
Yeah.
Imagine great. This one. Imagine you're trying to ward to a bush and a Syndra magically pop down and stun you. See, that's why. Oh, see, okay, so let's see what happened here. This is an easy kill. Oh my god, look at that damage. You killed her, but the problem is your stack deck was down, so you have to use Flash to escape. But you see how much damage you can do?
Yeah.
You can 100 to 0 a Nidalee. Alright, so let's skim through this one. You're going to farm from here. Alright, so you're going to skim through it. Skim, 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 skim. Alright, so you're going to heal up. You finally got your Zhonya's. Alright, so let's take a look here. What do we see here? We see a
Syndra.
A Syndra. Now at this point, what should he have done?
Ulti behind
yes.
her?
No, not ulti an ulti behind her. Just ulti to see where the teammates are. If she's alone, commit. That's why we use ulti for is to see if the teammate is alone. The moment you predict that they're alone, ultimate just to make sure. If they are alone, commit to it. You have your hourglass to save you in case you're going to a sticky situation. Right?
Yeah.
Alright, so that's what I want you to learn as well. You don't always use your ultimate to gank. You can also use it for vision control. Alright, so let's take a look at this one. Now again here. Alright, for example, pretend you ulted here, correct?
Yeah.
Let's remove Fog of War. Is there any of their teammates here? Do you see anyone? Just
Teemo.
Only Teemo, but is there anybody else here around here?
No.
No, is it just her?
Yes.
Is that an easy kill?
Yes.
Alright, so let's see what you did here. Alright, finally ulted. Alright, so you... Alright, so you killed her. You activate your Zhonya's. Alright, so you're gonna go for a Teemo. Very nice stun over the wall. You're gonna recall. Alright, so let's see what happened here. You're gonna skim, skim, skim. You're gonna take dragon. Alright, so you're gonna push top lane. There's a magical Syndra there. Alright, so there was a good stun. Let's take a review at that again. Let's see what you're positioning here. I want to take a look at this slowly. Alright, so you got the gold card up. Very good stun on... Yeah, on the Teemo, since he was stunned. Since Syndra ran back. You backed off. Karma kills Teemo. You guys decided to push. Man, look at that damage. Alright. No. Let's take a look at this one. I was focusing on Lee Sin. Alright, so let's take a look at this one. Alright. Alright, so you decided to stun the Syndra. The Syndra was shielded. So, let's take a look at this slowly. Alright, so let's take a look at you. Alright, so they decided to dive. And he got killed. You pulled out a gold card. No, you pulled out a blue card. And you look at yourself. Who's overcommitting?
Me.
You're overcommitting. If they tend to tower dive and nobody's following up, doesn't mean you should follow up as well.
Okay.
Stay in the back until you have a gold card ready again. But you pulled out a different card. And you got exhausted as well. Alright, so you take the tower here. Alright, Kog'Maw got a double kill. Alright, so let's take a look at this. Skim through it. Looks like you're gonna get a Rabadon's death cap.
Also, would Rapid Fire Cannon be decent on Twisted Fate just because it gives him the extra range
on
his
death card? No. It's not about the extra range, it's about how much damage you're doing. Okay, so considering this, if you're trading an item that gives, for example, 80 ability power for a Rapid Fire Cannon, how much damage are you actually missing?
A lot.
Okay, you may have the extra range, that's great, but it doesn't amplify any of your abilities. Even though you're there just to throw a gold card and press Q, you're not a person to always have that range. You're just there to throw a gold card. And also, you're using your ultimate to gap close people. Let's take a look at this. Anybody here with a rapid fire cannon? Of course not. Let's see. Rapid fire cannon. Alright, so let's take a look at this attack modifier here. So it gives you extra range. It gives you 5% movement speed. It gives you 30% attack speed. And gives you a 30% critical chance. And you get 35% increased range with a max of 150 plus range. And when at max level, your fire cannon deals 160 bonus damage. Alright, so let's talk about 160 bonus damage. On an auto, or you want extra ability power on all three of your abilities that use ability power. Correct?
Yes.
See? You gain no benefit with rapid fire cannon except range, which is a good thing, but you're missing out damage. So you're gonna get Baron here, correct? And I think pretty much here you're gonna end the game with a push.
Yeah.
You're gonna end the game with a push here. Let's just see end game. Alright, so you kill Nidalee. Okay. Alright, so let's talk about it. What do you think is a perfect time here?
Push.
You push after your ulti. Okay, so let's talk about this one. Alright, four people are dead. Alright, so you're gonna push after you get the kill. You're gonna push. Forget about Teemo, you do have Baron buff. And yeah, you're gonna end the game here. Okay, so we're gonna talk about what happened in the beginning. What happened in the beginning here?
I played too passively, and I missed out on a kill.
You missed out on a kill. Alright. This is the only thing I see that's wrong, is that you are underestimating yourself a bit. Don't always play passive in lane. Did you know you can play aggressive without pushing a lane? Does it mean an aggressive player is hitting your minions and pushing you is aggressive? No. Being aggressive is committing like that. That's an easy commit. But you're always scared to commit. And we're going to have to kill that, all right? In this game, all I see is that you're great with warding. Just buy a blue totem next. And if you have to, buy an Abyssal Scepter second.
Okay.
Against maybe Syndra, and you have a Nidalee jungle, they both do magic damage. And it'll help nullify that damage. So that's why I want you to learn from this one, is about that. There's nothing, I'm trying to pinpoint what else to help you out with. Oh yeah, just remember, when your Thunder Lords is up, use that. Just remember, with your stacked deck, you just require two abilities, which is an auto and ability to proc your Thunder Lords. Okay. Because what do you see here?
An easy kill.
And what did she do to you? She punished you what you didn't do to her. She used what you could have done against her. So that's the only thing I want to pinpoint, is that you're great in laning phase. Just be aware. One thing I like is that you've been playing League less than a year and you know how to ward. That's great. That's why I love seeing this. You're warding better than majority of the bronze players I've seen. You're warding more than a silver player I coached. That's on my stream right now. I'm talking to you, Dolby. Do you see this? A bronze 3 is warding more than you. This is something you need to learn as well. But your warding is spot on. I love how you put pink wards. I see you potential in climbing. It's just that maybe the reason why you're not winning these games is because you're missing out on...
Kills.
No, it's not missing out on kills. It's missing out on opportunities. Killing is not just an opportunity. It can be sieging, it can be ulting, it can be clearing waves, it can be pushing. Those are opportunities that you're missing out. Whenever Syndra's back home, push the lane, get the tower, you have your ultimate, look for another lane to gank. And second of all, mana management. Always look at your mana, because you always have a blue card to give you mana.
Okay.
Alright, so that's why I want you to learn. See, you got a blue card here. So that's why I want you to learn. So the three things I want you to learn. Mana management, opportunities, roaming with your ultimate.
Okay.
That's why I want you. So I hope you learned something from this replay. Hopefully you learned a couple of things. Do you have like any other questions you want to go over with, if I'm missing anything?
I don't think so.
Okay, you don't think so? Okay, that's completely fine. But you know, hey, the coaching is not always over. Just if I have an open session again, give me another replay to look at. I want to see more of your recent plays, not your past plays from this one. I want to see more of what you improved from the last time I coached you.
Okay.
So I can pinpoint more and more. I don't want to dump everything at you, because if I dump everything at you, I'm pretty sure you're not going to remember. So what you remember now is just opportunities, mana management, roaming with your ultimate. The warding is spot on, so I don't have to capitalize on that one. But those are the three things I want you to learn. And whenever I'm gonna coach you in the future, provide me with a more recent replay so we can go over more things.
Okay.
All right. So, anyways, Fox, thank you so much for having me to coach you.
Thank you.
Yeah. Hopefully, you learned something from this one. Not to make me, you know, a better coach, and it's also free. If you can, please rate how well I coach you on the website, and also give an honest review, all right?
Okay.
All right, thank you so much, and hey, good luck on Summer's Rift, and hopefully you climb ELO that way, because for a person who played less than a month, but is this great, he's just missing a little bit on the kills and opportunities here, you're doing fine. You can get yourself out of silver. Yes, out of silver with these plays that you're missing. All right? This is something you're doing, just missing out on opportunities. The moment you can find these opportunities, you can say goodbye to bronze.
Okay.
All right. Take care, Fox, all right?
Okay. Thank you.
All right,
bye.
No problem. Later.